In this video, what I want to show you is the installation of the deep joists to the floor for the second story of this house. I'm going to show you two different methods or two different materials that you can use and how you go about blocking them so they don't want to fall over. So the first material is your standard natural or timber, and of course you're going to purchase the lengths that are required and make sure that they are deep enough to span the distance that you require. And the biggest problem with natural timber is that it tends to twist and bow. So what we have to do is we have to stop it. And the way we do that is that the code in Australia says that every 1.8 metres or 1800 millimetres, what you have to do is put a row of blocking or strutting in to stop it from bowing. So what we've got here is what we call solid blocking. So that's just blocks of the similar material to the actual joist, a little bit narrower, nailed in between. The other option is to use what we call herringbone strutting. So 38 by 38 or 50 by 50 timber, just nailed into the angle. Both the blocks and the herringbone strutting are usually a little bit less, a little bit narrower than the actual joists, just so we don't get any chance of them sticking up and disturbing the floor. And especially with the solid blocks, leaving them a little bit short just allows for some airflow to move around in the joists. So that's our natural timber blocked and using herringbone strutting every 1.8 metres to stop it from twisting and bowing. The other option we can use, and the most popular option nowadays, is LVL and I-beams. In this case we have a fairly long span through here, so I've installed a steel beam that transfers all the way through to the floor, both sides, and throw in our I-beams and our LVLs. The LVLs are the more structural members. They're there to carry the weight. And because we've got an opening here for a stairwell, I've got an LVL on both sides to pick up the extra weight that this little trimmer would place, because it's carrying the load of those two joists there. The rest of the floors are I-beams or I-joists or whatever the particular manufacturer wants to call them. Very lightweight and a lot longer span. You can actually buy them in pretty much any length that you want, so there's no need to join them over a wall. They still only have a certain span, but you can just put continuous lengths all the way through, no need to join them. In this case we've had to join them on the steel beam, so what we do, again, to manufacturer's instructions, you can cut into the top and bottom flange of the beam. I think off the top of my head it's about 12 mil is the maximum, so you need to fit it around the beam as tightly as you can. And then of course we need to block these to stop them from falling over, but we only have to block the ends, so we just use the same material, just the offcuts, they just get cut in between, and the gap here allows for the airflow. On the other end, the other option is to use what they call a rim board, which is just basically a piece of 20mm ply which has been cut to the same height as a joist, and it gets nailed onto the end, and that stops the joist from falling over. We also need to make sure that we block them at the steel to stop these sliding along the steel, so that locks all the joists in. The big advantage of the I-joists is they don't need to be blocked in the middle. Only thing you have to do in the centre of the spans is just tack them in place with a bit of a batten while you're laying the floor, and then as you lay the floor that can come out, and that'll hold the joist straight while you're laying the floor. Other thing you need to do before you finish your floor is you need to make sure that you've got trimmers above all your internal walls that are running in the same direction as the wall. So a line of trimmers through there, that'll pick up this ceiling later on. So there you go, there's our deep joists installed into this job using either natural timber or a man-made timber product to create our floor for our second story.